It is covered under first unit. Introduction part. Here we discuss very detailed, in weatherings. Generally, what is weathering? So any material, any mass of material due to geological agents, they're getting eroded or rake. After that, it travels and deposits. That weathered material is nothing, process, entire process is nothing but weathering. Here, first, any mass material, they're getting breakage. Due to geological agents. So after getting breakage, it should be travel. If it is doesn't travel, that is residue. It travels or migrates one place to another place, that is transportation. This is the thing. So what is happening? Any rock mass body. What are the rocks? You already know. Igneous. Transportation, deposition. Sediment rocks are formed. Ultimate rock deposition is in the lowland area or any lakes, deltas, ocean. Metamorphic. Meta means change. Morphic means surface features. What are the existing of surface features? So change of weight. How it change? Due to high temperature. Second one is In exam point of view, okay, they ask you define weathering, classify the weathering. So at same time, sometimes they stress on the so granite, okay, due to weathering, granite what it gets affects, okay. So and due to weathering, what are the damage will occur in dams and reservoirs. Okay, the concept is same. Okay, concept is same. There is no difference. Okay, so due to geological agents, the rock mass bodies are getting destroyed. Okay, and so remove the field like air weather. So first one is about physical weather. Physical weather. Slowly to lose their edges that convert into rounded wind blows, okay, it destroys everything. So in this particularly desert regions, entire granitic wall was, they lost their strength and they lost all body measures and they converted into sand. Okay, so these sand materials collision each other and travel very long region downward and convert into sand dunes. This thing happened especially in the Canada, okay, especially in glacier region, marine condition is. Okay, so these are all the physical weather. Now we are going to the chemical weather. In chemical weather, there are hydrolysis processes. Okay. Hydrolysis function just like a water, okay. If water add with the carbon monoxide or carbon dioxide, they are converted into acid. That acid more harmful, okay, for the weather, more harmful for all materials which are present on the earth. So they are getting the disintegration from, sometimes they are called decomposition. Physical weather generally observe the disintegration. In chemical weathering, we can observe the decomposition. Here, disintegration and some part of decomposition both is there. Okay. Biological engineering, mostly decomposition. Both action is going on. Disintegration, decomposition of the rock mass body is nothing but weathering. That is the shortest definition. Okay, in a hydrolysis process, H2O, okay, is combined with the any carbon acid, carbonic materials, okay, carbon gases. The result is carbon acid gases. Salt, okay, so this water, okay, is diluted the most of the materials, okay. They are after dilution, they are transported and deposited there. It creates the some type of disintegration, chemical composition. So there's like limestone material, okay, travel the long regions and dilute it. And oxidation also, okay, and carbonation also. These are names itself give the clarity, okay, oxygen, some other material and convert into acid nature and carbonation also. Okay, carbon generally is harmful for all of it. Biological weathering generally, you know, plant bodies, leeches, all these particular organisms, they are passes through these crack zones and break these boulders on rocks, okay, these roots are sometimes leeches, they release the acids and disintegrate and decompose the materials. This is thing, okay, so brief explanation of the weathering. Thank you for listening. Lending viewers.